The idlis are soft, but you can feel the texture of the idli as you're eating it. So when you taste the pongal with the chutney, it's transformed to a whole new savoury, spicy level.
Every neighbourhood has its own set of popular eateries. The popularity of this tiny eatery or store right here in Malleshwaram that I'm about to visit today far outsurpasses the neighbourhood that it's located in. In fact, all of Bengaluru craves for the super soft idlis of Veena Stores. This store has been in existence for the last 40 odd years. It's nothing much, it's just a small little store. You pick your food, you stand on the road and you eat. But despite that, if you just look around me, there are people tucking into their morning tiffin. So there's a menu, very short menu. You got the idli, vada, you got the kesari bath, khara bath, shavige. Then you have the pongal, which is again on the rice preparation. But then they also have the sweet pongal. And I've heard about the sweet pongal too, in addition to the idli vada. ಏನೇನು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬರ್ತಿರೋದು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ.
ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ ಇದೆ.
ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ, ಸೊ ಏನು ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ ಉಪ್ಪಿಟ್ಟು ಸರ್. ಸರ್ ನನಗೆ ಒಂದು ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ ಕೊಡಿ, ಚೌ ಚೌ ಬಾತ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಒಂದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವೀಟ್ ಖಾರ ಪೊಂಗಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಿ. ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಿಹೈವ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಮಚ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಕ್ರೌಡ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್, ಯು ನೋ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಟು ಸರ್ವ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಔಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. First, idli vade kodi. So you have to jostle a bit for your order, but then such is the nature of the experience here at Veena Stores. Thank you, sir. Chutney aakade. Okay. So I've got my steaming hot idlis and the vada and the chutney, of course, here. Thank you. I love the fragrant aroma that's coming from the idli. It's very mellow, very inviting. I'm going to taste the idli first just by itself. I want to get a sense of this hugely popular idli that all of Bengaluru is crazy about. You know, the idli is soft yet springy to the touch, and it has this gentle steamed flavor. Let's taste the idli now with the chutney. So the chutney has a whole bunch of things going into it. So you've got some, I'm sure there's some curry leaf, there's some chilli. That chutney packs a zesty punch. It's spicy, and just what you need with this super soft idlis. The idlis are soft, but you can feel the texture of the idli as you're eating it. I think I'm going to go and get some more chutney. I need all that chutney to soak up the idli and also the vada that I'm going to try next. But the vada feels crunchy to the touch. And it feels crisp and dry, very little oil that I have on my fingertips even after touching the vada. I'm going to taste this vada just by itself first. That vada is crunchy, crispy and porous inside. I don't spot any other peppers or anything like that in the vada. There's just that, those flecks of coconut that I've tasted. What brings the idli and the vada alive is definitely this chutney. This chutney has so much flavor. It's got all that coconut and then it's got the spice. It's got the chilli, I think there's some mint. It's so flavorful. Well, many places in Bengaluru are a stand and eat affair, but Veena Stores is a stand and eat on the road affair. So if you look around, people are literally standing on the footpath. There's not much of a footpath right now because there's some work happening, as you can look around. But people don't mind that. They're here for their idli vada. I mean, almost everybody here has an idli vada. The other dishes that follow are a mere add-on. But the star here, I'm told, is the idli vada. And when I tasted this, it certainly feels that way. Again, sir, khara bath.
Upma.
Upma.
Very fine upma, no garlic, no onion.
No garlic, no onion.
Plain upma.
Andre, upma andre same, kara baat hai.
Only Veena Store is available, no other place.
No other place.
Some places they call it upma.
Some places kara baat.
Upma is kara baat.
How's the idli vada? Good. How long have you been coming here? 2 years. And every time you eat idli vada. Karabat. So young, old, Veena Stores is popular with everybody. Chow Chow Bath. As you can see, there's a bit of a hustle to get your food, but it's all worth it. Thank you, sir. Thank you. So there you go, I have my Chow Chow Bath right here. So this is the Khara Bath and this is the Kesari Bath. Khara Bath is a savory semolina preparation, and then the Kesari Bath is a sweet semolina preparation, and together the combination in Karnataka is called a Chow Chow Bath. I don't know how that name came about, but it certainly sounds appealing. The Khara Bath certainly looks very alluring. It's moist and you can see there's some peas, there's some chilli. I also spot what may be peanuts, I'm not sure, and of course the curry leaf. And there is no onion, garlic that's used in the food here. I'm also told that there is a sizable Jain community that lives in the neighborhood, and perhaps that's also got to do with the fact that there is no onion, garlic that's used in any of the preparations right here at Veena Stores. That bite was soft, creamy and flavorful. You know, the fact that there is no onion, no garlic, but it still packs in all that flavor thanks to the chili that it has in it, thanks to the curry leaves, the tomatoes, the fried lentils that have also gone into it. In fact, it's quite a spicy dish, but it's so soft and creamy. And of course, you also have the peas for that added pop. This is definitely big on flavors. You also have the roasted peanut that gives it that deep flavor. In fact, the flavor of the Khara Bath or the Uppittu or the Upma lingers long on your palate, even after you've swallowed a spoonful. That's how flavorful this is. After that spicy hit, I now need some of the Kesari Bath, the sweeter component of this Chow Chow Bath. If any of you out there know why this concoction is called a Chow Chow Bath, do let me know in the comments below. There's also some banana in this that I just tasted. So the Kesari Bath by itself is not too sweet, but as you bite into the raisin, you have that sudden burst of sweetness. There's also some cashew that lends it a bit of toastiness. I love the fact that this Kesari Bath isn't too sweet. You know, sometimes you taste a Kesari Bath and it's very, very sweet, but this one is not too sweet at all. So the raisin is just lightly fried. It's not roasted too much. So you have that very mellow flavor of this Kesari Bath, quite in contrast to the flavorful burst that you got from the Khara Bath. So it's quite a yin-yang sort of a combination, this Chow Chow Bath. Super delicious. In fact, when I was looking up Veena Stores, people raved a lot about the idli and the vada, and the idli was certainly very good. But even this combination Chow Chow Bath that I had of the Kesari Bath and the Khara Bath is quite pleasing in itself. Definitely something that you can try when you're here at Veena Stores. I'm going to taste a bit of the Khara Bath and the Kesari Bath together. So there you go, I have a bit of the Kesari Bath, the sweet Kesari Bath and the spicy Khara Bath. That's very interesting. So because you've taken the sweet and the savory together, the sweet actually enhances the savory punch of the Khara Bath. So with the Khara Bath, I can taste that spice and I can also taste that salty savoriness. But it's quite an interesting sort of a combo. So much so that I'm going to finish the last of my Chow Chow Bath combination. It's quite an interesting dish. I'm already full up, but I need to try that pongal. I've heard a lot of things about the pongal, and they do a gatti pongal here, which is a firm pongal. So let's get a pongal and see what the pongal is all about. Thank you. You didn't chutney utte ke din tha
jo chutney hai aapko tar over chutney
hai
aapko.
I have the last of the preparations from Veena Stores that I'm going to try today. I've got the pongal combination. This is a Khara pongal or the savory pongal, and then I have the sweet pongal. I think the sweet pongal is made with jaggery, so it's also called a jaggery pongal. Now when I was trying the Chow Chow Bath, I felt that it was very savoury, very flavourful, so it didn't need that chutney, that's what I felt. But I thought I must get a bit of the chutney with the Kara Pongal. It looks a little mellower as compared to the bright looking Kara Bath. Let's begin with what I'm hoping will be a delicious bite of the sweet pongal. You know, you can taste the jaggery that's in that sweet pongal and also some camphor, edible camphor that's been used to flavour the pongal. But there's also a certain graininess in texture, and I suspect there's some lentils that have also gone into this sweet pongal, and that gives it that grainy sort of a texture. So you have that bite of that plum short rice that this sweet pongal is made of, and then you also have that grainy texture of the lentils that have gone into it. It's quite a richly flavoured dish as compared to the kesari bath that I just tried. I'm going to next try the rice pongal, the khara pongal. I think there's some pepper here. There's also some cumin seeds that I can see. It's not as creamy as the khara bath and the kesari bath, but this is meant to be a gatti pongal, so it's a little firmer. So you definitely have the cumin seeds that's flavouring this khara pongal, and then you have that peppery bite of the whole peppercorns. So the rice in this pongal is almost crushed to a paste as opposed to the grains that you could still find in the sweet pongal. It's a little mellow in its flavour, other than the cumin and the peppercorn when you bite into it. So I'm going to take a bit of the chutney, the coconut mint chutney, and taste it with a bit of the khara pongal. I think this pongal needs that chutney to elevate the flavours. So when you taste the pongal with the chutney, it's transformed to a whole new savoury, spicy level. You're standing roadside and there's some construction work happening. But notwithstanding that, Veena Stores has its loyal patrons who will stand on the road and eat no matter what's happening around. I think I'm going to try and find a quieter spot there to finish the rest of my sweet pongal. Oh, there you have it. I have a quieter spot on the middle of a busy street to finish my sweet pongal. It also has some nuts and some raisin that I just tasted. So between the khara pongal and the sweet pongal, I'm definitely a fan of the sweet pongal. I think if you're here at Veena Stores, definitely something that you must try. Some coffee to end. What was a large breakfast here at Veena Stores? Sir, coffee geshtu? Solpa adu sakare kammi solpa strong agboda. So you also have some of these snacks that you can buy. So you've got some chikki, you've got some oppattu, you've got some mixture made of puff rice, some laddu. So some snacks to take away from Veena Stores. And I'm told that this store originally began as a condiment store. Got some coffee to end my meal here at Veena Stores. The coffee is nice, thick and strong. Just what you need after tasting 6 dishes here at Veena Stores. You know, you're literally eating in a state of chaos here at Veena Stores. There's traffic that's flowing by, there's cars, vehicles honking. Yet, if you look at people here, they're standing still and enjoying their Veena Stores breakfast. Whether it's the Idli Vada, whether it's the Chow Chow Bath, or the sweet pongal. Such is the allure of what began and what still is actually a tiny little store right here in the heart of Malleshwaram. Come here just for the food. There are no thrills, no frills, definitely no bells and whistles, but it's all about the food here. So if you're in Bengaluru, do check out Veena Stores for that piping hot idli. And until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe, be happy, and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share, and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the Support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!